Imagine if someone asked you to describe me, but all you had to go on was this picture from when I was 5 years old. You'd say I was maybe 4 feet tall, with bangs, and a really cool Pooh Bear backpack. But 20 years later, I hardly look anything like that. And the same goes for wetlands. They take a long time to become fully grown, and their appearance can change dramatically over the years. Species of plants might be lost or gained, or an unwanted invasive species might take over. Yet wetlands that are restored through a state program called wetland banking are only monitored for 5 years. If we wanted to assess the health of those wetlands a decade or two later, all we'd have to go on is data from when these wetlands were, well, kids. And that's a huge problem for two reasons. First, we need to know if our wetlands are healthy because they provide vital services that benefit our well-being. They help with flood control and they purify our water, sort of like the Brita filter of ecosystems. Unfortunately, we've destroyed half of all wetlands in the US by converting them to farmland throughout history. The goal of restoration, then, is to get these wetlands back up and running by reestablishing or repairing their soil, water, and plants. But since we only monitor for 5 years, we're unsure if we ever fully achieve this goal. Second, we need to know if the money the state invests in restoration is worth it. To reestablish a wetland's vegetation, land managers cover the site with a mixture of seeds from different plant species. These seed mixes are expensive, costing hundreds of dollars per acre, and when tens or hundreds of acres are seeded at a time, that adds up. Given these substantial costs, it seems crazy that beyond the first 5 years, we don't know if these seed mixes are even working. So that is exactly what I investigated with my thesis research. I revisited wetland bank sites that are about a decade old and recorded every species of plant present and how much area they cover. I've used this data to evaluate how some of the state's commonly used seed mixes perform over time. I've found that one of the mixes consistently gets taken over by an invasive cattail. I've also discovered that some species, like Big Bluestem, grow really well, while others, like the blazing stars and irises, just aren't showing up. This information will help the state adjust which species are included in the mixes, ensuring we're getting the most bang for our restoration buck. Moreover, understanding when restoration efforts are working and when they're not will improve long-term outcomes, which means better functioning, healthier wetlands. Remember, it's our well-being and our money on the line, so it just makes sense to conduct long-term monitoring and to not abandon our efforts before these wetlands have had the chance to grow up.